Life on Earth is breathtaking, diverse, resilient, mysterious, and infinitely complex. Every living thing, from microscopic cells to massive underwater giants, are all interconnected within the biosphere that we call home, relying on each other for survival. Welcome, my friends, to Life Science. I'm Justin, and I'll be your host as we begin to explore this fascinating scientific field together. In this introduction lesson, we will define what life science is, describe how this course is structured, and we'll explain why learning this field of science is so important, not just for you or me, but for every living thing we share our planet with. Let's get into it. Life science is, you guessed it, the study of life. It also has another name that you might be familiar with, biology. Life scientists, also called biologists, attempt to answer questions related to living things. This includes questions like, why can't penguins fly? Or why do the leaves change color in the fall? Or even, what makes something alive in the first place? If any of these questions piqued your curiosity, then you're in the right place. What are some questions that you have about living things? Pause the video here to jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. Did you come up with any good ones? If you did, then you are already thinking like a scientist. All right, let's take a look at what we can expect from this course. In Unit 1, The Nature of Science, we'll quickly get you up to speed on how biologists work to answer important questions. We'll cover important topics, such as how to effectively use the scientific method, the different types of scientific investigations, measuring data, organizing and analyzing that data, and finally, communicating your results in a helpful way. For Unit 2, we will be addressing the question, what are cells and how are they structured? From the tiniest bacterium to the largest whales, every living thing is made up of these tiny building blocks. In this unit, we'll explore the various kinds of cells and what makes them unique. In Unit 3, we'll ask, what are the processes or tasks that cells perform in order to keep themselves healthy? Whether it's taking in nutrients, expelling wastes, or just growing and reproducing, cells always have a process that they follow. From there, we'll move on to Unit 4, where we'll take a look at the blueprints for life as we study DNA and genetics. If you've ever wondered why you or your family members look the way you do, or even why two members of the same species of animal can look completely different, you'll find the answer in this unit. In Unit 5, we'll explore the incredible diversity of life on Earth, answering the question, how do scientists organize and understand millions of different living species? We'll take a closer look at the unique characteristics of all different forms of life, from trees to wolves to living things you've probably never even heard of. In Unit 6, we'll circle back to the living things that we know best, ourselves. In this unit, we'll take a look at the fascinating complexity of the human body systems, and we'll discover how these systems work together to help keep us healthy. By the end of this unit, you'll have a much deeper understanding of the incredible machine that is the human body, including how to take care of your own. Finally, in Unit 7, we will take everything we've learned so far and apply it to the field of ecology, focusing on the question, how do living things interact with each other? Every living thing has a role to play in the grand scheme of life on Earth. We all coexist in a delicate balance, and there are many things that can throw this balance off. By the end of this unit, you'll have a newfound appreciation for the awe-inspiring complexity of our natural world, and the important role that each of us can play in preserving it for future generations. So, which unit are you the most excited for? Pause the video here and write down your answer in your guided notes. Great choice. So, life science is fascinating, but we don't study it just because it's interesting. It's super important, too. For example, life science is the foundation for modern medicine, which has allowed people to live much longer and much more comfortably. In addition, it's also helped us provide nutritious food to billions of people around the world by helping us grow better crops and raise stronger livestock. Additionally, professions rooted in physiology, such as physical therapy, help people and animals recover from injuries and chronic pain. Finally, life science helps us understand that all living things are connected, so that we can make better decisions about how we interact with nature. And, of course, this is just a few of the reasons why life science is awesome. It's nowhere near all of them. So join me on this journey of discovery and exploration as we dive deep into the fascinating world of life science. Together, we can uncover the secrets of the natural world and use our knowledge to build a brighter, more sustainable future for ourselves and for generations to come. I hope you're ready to think like a scientist, because that's exactly what we're going to be learning how to do in our next lesson. Until then, I'm Justin, and remember, life is full of wonders. So keep on learning and don't ever stop wondering. Hey.